Namashivaya student, welcome to the class. In this class, we will discuss about diverse settings and different cultures. Student, since a very small age, you have been taught that humans live in diverse geographical conditions, like from the hot desert of Sahara to the cold desert of Ladakh, from the coastal areas to the higher mountains. Human settlements can be seen everywhere, and their clothes, foods and culture much depends on their surroundings. Even the art, paintings, music, dance, this also greatly influenced by their surroundings. So we can say that humans live in a variety of natural settings, like in the mountains and plains, in forests and clear lands, in deserts and river valleys, in islands and mainlands. And they also inhabit different social setup, like in villages, towns and cities. In different environments, people adopt different strategies to cope with the natural and social conditions. This leads to the emergence of diverse ways of life or culture. Disparities in coping mechanism were evident during the devastating tsunami of 26 December 2004, which affected some parts of the Tamil Nadu and Kerala coast, as well as the Andaman and Nicobar Islands in India. People on the mainland and islands are integrated into a relatively modern way of life. The fisher folk and the service personnel in the islands were caught unaware and suffered large-scale devastation and much losses of life. On the other hand, the primitive tribal communities in the islands, like the Onges, Jarawas, Great Andamanis or Champans, who had no access to modern science and technology, foresaw the calamity based on their experiential knowledge and saved themselves by moving on to higher grounds. This shows that having access to modern science and technology does not make modern cultures superior to the tribal cultures of the islands. Hence, cultures cannot be ranked but can be judged adequate or inadequate in the terms of their ability to cope with the strains imposed by nature. So here it is clear for us that the term culture cannot be judged as superior or inferior on the basis of its access to modern science and technology. It is totally depends on its ability to cope with the strains imposed by nature. Here, I want to add one more example. Like when British ruled in India, they found Indian culture as inferior and their Western culture as superior. And slowly, slowly, a group of Indians also started to believe the same. And hence, lot many changes were adopted by the Indians, which was not logical. Like, take the example of clothing. As we know that India's climate is hot, so wearing kurtas pajama or cotton clothes is a part of Indian culture because it helps us to cope up with the Indian climate. And European people dressed themselves as per their climatic condition. And same is applicable in our food habits also. So here, how does the term superior or inferior comes? So in simple word, we can say that our culture is totally influenced by our geographical condition and it is suitable for us. So we should not debate about this superiority or inferiority. In our next class, we will discussed about the definition of culture. So till then, take care of yourself. Namah Shivaya.